We have a pipe here. Under the pipe, a cube has been placed in such a way that a portion of it interferes with the pipe. The aim here is to create an indent in the pipe to accommodate the cube. This indent needs to have the same shell thickness as a pipe. We want to create the indent in a way that changes as the size and position of the cube changes. This could easily have been an example with two components. To reduce the complexity and to present the workflow in a clearer manner, I'm going to demonstrate this with two bodies. You should be able to implement the same workflow in a multi-component environment. Theoretically, the fastest way in this particular example would be to use the cube to cut into a solid cylinder and then perform the shell at the last step. The workflow shown here will be more appropriate for cases where changing the order of features in the timeline might be difficult or where the pipe is an imported model. The basic summary of the workflow is to copy the overlapping volume of the cube, add it to the pipe, and perform a shell from there. We can certainly employ the split body and combine commands to achieve this, but let's try using the boundary fill command instead. The boundary fill command is almost an all-in-one command. It is able to split, combine, and copy bodies all at the same time, reducing many steps. Let's go to Create, Boundary Fill. Select the pipe and the cube as tools. Fusion analyzes the overlapping volumes and creates cells for selection. Let's change the environment to dark sky so that we can see the cells better. Go to Display Settings, Environment, Dark Sky. Click on the select box to start selecting the cells. As we hover over the checkboxes, the corresponding cell changes into a slightly paler green. Select these three cells. Set operation to new body. By selecting this, these three cells will combine into a new body. We want to retain the original cube, so do not check the Remove Tools option. This will also retain the original pipe. Let's hide all the bodies and review them one by one. The original pipe has been retained. I'm going to rename and hide it. The original cube has also been retained. Both the original pipe and the original cube are unharmed in this process. This is a new body created in a boundary fill operation. It has a copy of the overlapping portion of the cube merged into a copy of the pipe. If we proceed to shell at this point, it will not give us the recess that we need. We need to offset these faces. Go to Modify, Offset Face. Select these faces. For the offset distance, we need to offset by the sum total of the shell's thickness and any clearance that you need. In this case, the pipe thickness is 3 mm. I need a clearance of 1 mm between the pipe and the cube. So let's offset these faces by 4 mm. Go to Modify Shell. Select the outer face of the pipe. Set the same shell thickness as the pipe. Let's bring back the cube and take a look at the cross section. Let's try changing the size and position of the cube.